Welcome back to latest TV news. Now, as you may have seen in the first half, there's a lot of uncertainty around Brexit at the moment and what that means for the British economy. But an initiative right on our doorstep is moving towards an idea around a sharing economy. The Brighton and Hove Sharing City event will be right here at the latest music bar tomorrow night. A little earlier today, Yael Bruer caught up with one of the organisers.
But you're here today to talk about a particular event that you're organising in Brighton at the latest. Tell us a little bit about the event first. It's all to do with sharing.
It is. Well, there's this whole concept of sharing cities. And a sharing city is a city that is fair and is open and smart city that opens up access to available resources for all citizens. It's very much about people being able to find and access the goods and services they need to lead their everyday lives. And what we do know is that by 2050, over 70% of the global population will live in urban areas, will live in cities. And so the pressures on cities are extreme. And we know that with this increased population, it's going to be incredibly important that cities smartly address these pressing problems of the future.
So we're talking about sharing resources within the cities. Give me examples.
So, for example, we know that housing, there are constraints on housing, particularly for those who are on low incomes. And what a sharing city does is it opens up access to spaces that may have been abandoned, that spaces that may not be fully served. And it's providing access to those who need that kind of housing, or who need housing, for the citizens themselves. It's also, a sharing city is also about opening up the abundance of a city. So to look at a city in one context, we know that globally there are over £3.5 trillion worth of idle resources in the world. And that's everything from food and housing, all the kinds of goods that we need.
And when you say idle, it means unused, disused,
it means
thrown
they're
away?
Disused, they're unused, they're thrown away. Now, a sharing city looks at this in the context of waste is simply resource in the wrong place. And it's about enabling the citizens to access that abundance that exists. Because you can see a city in a way as a warehouse that has everything in it that we need, but we just need to access it.
So you're talking about a city, you're not talking about individuals. So if I lend my neighbour a cup of sugar, that's not what you're after. You're not after individuals who should be more proactive about sharing resources, but for the city to take responsibility, for Brighton Council to say, we're going to become an official sharing city?
So the city, this whole city movement, this sharing city movement, is basically both ground up, and also it's about cities themselves getting on board with this concept and opening up access to resources. But what we are seeing around the world is a multitude of cities, in fact there are about 80 now, who are opening up this kind of access and are enabling citizens to be able to access these idle resources in lots of different ways. So that might be, for example, it might be smart bike, shared bike systems like Bike Share that we have, for example, but it could also be community fridges, community laundrettes, it could be book sharing
schemes. What's a community fridge?
So a community fridge is a fridge that exists in a community centre, for example, where people can store their food, where if people have surplus food, they're able to share that with the community. It's there to avoid food waste, divert food from landfill. We have some phenomenal food sharing projects in the city. Brighton and Hove Food Partnership, for example, run all kinds of projects like the Real Junk Food Project, where we're seeing food that would otherwise go to landfill being diverted. And so a sharing city is very much about promoting this whole culture of sharing. So that does include you sharing a cup of tea with your neighbour, but it also means the city itself endorsing and enabling the sharing to happen. This is something that we want to promote, and it's actually something that we need to promote, because those very pressing global problems that I mentioned are only going to get worse. And so what we're seeing is that smart cities who are looking to the future, who are able to recognise that there are ways in which we have everything that we need right on our doorstep, but people need to be connected. They need to know where to discover and access these resources. And so this whole idea of this event is to bring people together in the city to demonstrate and for people to discover all of these different initiatives that already exist here, but also to catalyse and inspire other different sharing services.
So how are you proposing to do it? What is the event?
So the event itself, we have a whole evening of talks, inspiring talks. We've got examples globally. We have Tom Llewellyn, who's coming over from the US, who has co-written a book called Sharing Cities, with examples from cities all over the world, all kinds of examples from participatory budgeting, right the way through to food sharing schemes, job sharing schemes.
So is it like a manual? Is he coming to talk to us in Brighton about how to become a sharing city?
Well, Tom is going to provide us with some case studies. So we've got some really inspiring talks, but we also have lots and lots of examples in Brighton who are going to be represented here. So people will be able to discover all of the different sharing initiatives that are on their doorstep. But we also want people to have an experience, a fun experience, because ultimately this whole idea of a sharing city is also about fun and positive, and it's about people being able to access the resources they need, but also to connect with others. So we're going to have a whole evening of entertainment. We're going to have some crowd singing. We've got a community choir that are going to be here. We've got some crowd comedy, so that's participatory comedy.
So a comedian that would involve the audience.
That are going to involve the audience, exactly. We've got a skiffle band. We have Rivka Ravenna, who's written a song about sharing. She's a 15-year-old singer-songwriter. So we've got all sorts of incredible talent here in the city, and all of these performers are sharing their talents with us for that evening.